ज्ञानञ्जना शलाकाया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमद्भक्तिवेदान्ता स्वामिनिति नाम्ने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पश्चाच्यदेशतारिणे। वंशकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So I welcome everyone to our...
This meeting is being recorded.
Welcome everyone to our Sunday program for the Taipei Yatra. Today I want you to...
好，非常欢迎所有的奉献者参与今天的台湾 Yatra 所台北 Yatra 所办的这个讲座。
So today is an auspicious day. Today is actually the festival of Gundicha Marjana, which means the cleaning of the Gundicha temple.
今天是一个非常吉祥的日子，叫做 Gundicha Marjana， 也就是说这个是清洁这个打扫 Gundicha 庙的这个节庆。
And this is described, there's one chapter in the Madhya Lila of the Chaitanya Charitamrita, chapter number 12, entitled Cleansing of the Gundicha Temple.
那这个逍遥时光是在永恒的柴泰亚经中中篇逍遥的第十二章就是清理这个滚地茶庙的这个章节。
So this festival is in relation to Lord Jagannath, and it's celebrated originally in Jagannath Puri.
那这个逍遥时光是在就是 Jagannath Puri 那边所上演的一次逍遥时光，跟主 Jagannath 有关系。
Right, in Jagannath Puri, there's a very big temple and they have very big deities which have been worshipped there for 1,000 years or more.
那 Jagannath Puri 那边有一个非常非常大的 Jagannath 神庙它的历史非常的悠久，已经有好几千年的历史了。
Hey Krishna Maharaj, excuse me, we cannot see your video, is it on?
Well, I noticed none of you have your videos on, so I thought, why shouldn't I put my video on?
No, Maharaj, we would like to see you.
Well, do you think I wouldn't like to see you?
we can switch it on.
The thing is, you have to understand that, you know, for the China government, we consider it not to be very convenient to put
the
video on.
Yeah, that's okay then.
So...
Okay, so just continue, sorry.
So every year, they celebrate the Rath Yatra festival in Jagannath Puri.
所以在Jagannath Puri 那边，就是每年都有这个 Radha Yatra 弹车节的庆祝。
But 2 weeks before the Rath Yatra festival, they have the Snan Yatra or the bathing festival of Lord Jagannath.
可是在这个弹车节 坦车捷径之前的两周，有一个主扎嘎纳的沐浴的仪式。
And that festival, they say that is actually the birthday or the appearance day of Lord Jagannath when they do the bathing festival.
那据说这个主扎嘎纳的这个沐浴的节庆，事实上，其实就是主扎嘎纳的生日。
And then after the bathing festival, then Lord Jagannath goes into isolation or quarantine for some time, and we don't see the deities for 2 weeks.
就在主扎嘎纳的沐浴仪式之后呢，他会有两周人们都没有办法觐见主扎嘎纳，他就被单独的隔离开来。
So then when Lord Jagannath is finished with the 2 weeks of isolation or quarantine, then he comes out, and that's when the Rath Yatra festival takes place.
那他这两周的休养期就是过了之后，然后就是才是这个坛车节的开始。
So when Lord Jagannath appears, he comes out from the temple, the main temple where he resides, and he gets on the chariot, and the chariot is pulled down the road for a few kilometers to the temple of Gundicha.
那这个主扎嘎纳呢，会从这个大庙中离开，然后上这个坛车，然后行驶的几公里远，然后到达这个滚地场庙去。
There's a very big wide road between the main temple of Jagannath and the Gundicha temple.
从这个扎嘎纳庙到这个滚地场庙呢，这个是他们之间是有一条很大的、很宽广的道路，可以通达。
They have to pull the chariot. The chariots with, there's one chariot for Jagannath, one chariot for Balaram, one chariot for Subhadra. And the chariots are pulled by hand, and there's no brakes on the chariot.
那这个坛车呢，有三座坛车，有主扎嘎纳，还有Balaram，还有Subhadra。那他们是用人力来拉这个坛车，那中途都没有休息。
I think we have to ask everyone to put their mute on. Some people haven't got mute.
Excuse me, do you assign Chintami Radha as a co-host?
Me?
We tried to do it, but we could only do you as the co-host, but is she using the same account as yours? We couldn't make her the co-host. So, okay, I'll just, there's one person who is not muted, I'll mute them. Yeah.
Yes, please.
Okay.
Need to control their microphone.
Yes,
but yes.
Understand, yeah. Okay.
So the chariots are pulled down to the Gundicha temple, and the temple which they come out from, that's like Lord Jagannath's residence. But they're going to visit the Gundicha temple, which is like his parents' home. They're going to Vrindavan, they're going to see their family, they're going back home to see their family.
那这个主扎嘎纳就搭着这个坛车要到滚地场庙去，那这趟行程就很像是回家一样的，好像是要回去见他的家人的这种情感。
So the chariot festival was performed with the mood that we're bringing Krishna to Vrindavan.
所以这个坛车节呢，它是以一种这样的一种心情 一种心态，就是要把 Krishna 带回 Vrindavan 的这样的心态。
So the Gundicha temple represents Vrindavan, but it hasn't been used. The temple has been empty for a year since the last festival. That nobody has been there in the temple.
所以 Gundicha 庙它代表着就是 Vrindavan, 但是在弹车节庆，每一年的弹车节庆之间，整座庙。都是空荡荡的，大概有一年的时间都是闲置的。
And it's only at the time of the Rath Yatra that Lord Jagannath and Lord Balaram and Subhadra Maharani they come there and they stay in the Gundicha temple for 1 week.
只有在每年的坎车节庆的时候，主 Jagannath、Balaram、Subhadra， 他们就才会来到这个 Gundicha 庙待一周的时间。
So the day before the Rath Yatra, all the devotees will go to the Gundicha temple to clean that temple.
那在弹车节的前一天，奉献者们就会齐聚一堂到 Gundicha 庙去打扫这个庙宇。
And 500 years ago, Lord Chaitanya was living there in Jagannath Puri, and he would come and take part in the Rath Yatra festival.
500年前，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 他就是住在 Jagannath Puri， 他都会参与这个弹车节。
When Lord Jagannath, after the bathing ceremony of Lord Jagannath, then Lord Jagannath is not in the temple anymore. He goes into isolation for 2 weeks. So at that time, Lord Chaitanya would leave Jagannath Puri.And he would come back only after the 2 weeks was over.
在主Jagannath沐浴仪式之后，他会有两周的时间，他都是处在就是被隔离的一个状态。那只有在这个两周结束之后，他才会才能够出来在。再回到他的家里。You say, Maharaj?
Yeah. You had a question?
You say that after the 2 weeks, the Jagannath, Lord Jagannath can get back to
the temple.
Yeah.
Then
this is what you say?
Yeah, he comes out. He comes out. He's...
Okay. 他就可以出来了。
And Lord, but the day before the Rath Yatra, Lord Chaitanya would organize all the devotees to go to the Gundicha temple to clean the temple.
可是在这个弹车节庆的前一天，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他会组织奉献者们一起去打扫 Gundicha 庙。
First of all, Lord Chaitanya would go to see the he would go to see the person in charge of the temple, and he would go to see the senior most people there, and he would tell them that he wants to take all the devotees to Gundicha to do the cleaning of the temple.
那主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 首先他会去见这个管理这个庙的人。那些年长的人就是像庙里的总管，他会告诉他们说，他要带领奉献者去打扫滚地场庙。
So the, when the superintendent of the temple heard, then he was very pleased, and he said, "Yes, I've already been told by the king that I should cooperate with you and give whatever you need."
那这个庙里的总管听到主柴坦亚马阿巴布的要求，他非常的高兴。他说：“是的，国王已经有告诉我了，无论您需要什么，我都要配合您。”
Yeah, the king of Puri, he's also a great devotee, and he wanted very much to arrange everything for Lord Chaitanya's happiness.
那这个 Jagannapuri 的国王呢、也是一个、奉献者，那他、就是会为主、Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 安排所有的一切来取悦他。
So、he immediately said, I will give you 100 brooms and 100 buckets. Or, no,、not buckets, but、clay pots, because they use clay pots to bring the water.、
那、所以、国王、就是 让他的手下去准备、一百只扫帚，还有这个水罐，陶制的水罐。
So Lord Chaitanya got all his devotees and he personally gave each one of them a broom, or he would give other ones pots to carry.
那主柴堪亚马哈帕布他就亲自来分发这一百只扫帚、分别给奉献者们一人一把扫帚，然后还有一些人就是会 拿这个水罐。
So Lord Chaitanya then led all the devotees to the Gundicha temple and they began to clean.
就这样子，主柴堪亚马哈帕布就带领着这些奉献者们前往滚地茶庙去打扫庙宇。
And the people with the brooms, they were doing the sweeping. And those who had the pots, they had to go to the lake and collect water and bring buckets.Pots of water.
那些、拿着扫帚的人，他们就开始打扫这个庙宇。那还有一些拿着水罐的人，他们就到湖里去取水。
So first they swept everything, and they collected all the dust and all the sand and all the straw, and threw it outside.
首先、他们就开始打扫。这个庙里的这些、这些垃圾污染的东西、比方说那个灰尘、沙粒，还有那些稻草，把它们扫、扫出这个庙外。
They were cleaning not only the floor, they would clean the ceiling and the walls.
他们不止打扫地板，他们还、清理这个天花板，还有墙壁。
And there was one special altar made where the deities would be sitting, and they would lift the altar and they would clean everything around the altar.
然后他们还把、这个、庙里的、神坛的那个神像的那个座位、给拿开、把下面清扫干净之后，再把这个座位、归还原位。
And after they cleaned all the temple,Then the people came with the water and they threw the water. And they threw the water on the ceiling and the water ran down the walls and everywhere was flooding in water.
他们在、把这些、脏东西给、清理之后，他们会、拿了这个水罐水来，然后就往天花板上洒，然后天花板上的水、的水就顺着这个墙壁又流到地板上，所以、到处、都是这个、就是都是充满了水。
And then they would let the water run out of the building, you know, because there's drains here. So they'd open the drains and let the water run out, and then they would clean again.
然后就这样子，他们让从顺着天花板、顺着墙壁流下来的水。然后就会顺着庙里的这个出水口让它排出去，然后他们就再来从头再打扫一次。
And Lord Chaitanya would be personally taking part in the cleaning of the temple.
主柴堪亚马哈帕布他亲自来打扫、这个庙宇，滚迪查庙宇。
And sometimes he would be praising someone that you're doing very nicely, you're serving very good, you're cleaning very well. And other times he would be chastising people that, oh, you're not doing so well, you haven't collected very much dirt.
那有时候主柴堪亚马哈帕布他会赞美一些奉献者说，哦，你真的是你干得好，你打扫得非常干净，非做得非常好。有些时候 他也会指责一些奉献者，你看你还没有弄得很干净还可以再加强。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya was personally encouraging all the devotees to clean the temple very carefully.
So, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he 亲自鼓励着每一位奉献者承担起这个打扫庙宇的这个责任，要他们小心翼翼的清理这个庙宇。
They cleaned once, and then they cleaned the whole thing again.
他们打扫了一次之后，他们第二次再打扫一次。
And Lord Chaitanya would take his own personal cloth, and he would use his own cloth to clean.
甚至于主差参亚马哈帕布还亲自用他的衣服，他穿的衣服来打扫这个庙宇。
He wanted to show everyone how important it is to clean the temple very carefully.
他想教导奉献者们让大家了解这个把庙宇打扫的清洁一尘不染是多么重要的事情啊。
And after they cleaned everything inside, then they cleaned also outside.
当他们把庙宇打扫了窗明几净一尘不染之后，他们还继续在打扫庙外面的地方。
And they made sure all the sand and all the dust and the straw and whatever was should not be inside the temple, they made sure it was all taken far away from the temple.
他们小心翼翼地确保所有的灰尘、沙粒、这些、稻草、所有的这些垃圾污染的东西全部、都 清除干净。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya was teaching everyone how we should receive Lord Krishna in the heart.
主差参亚马哈帕布以这样的方法亲自教导着我们要如何的就是净化我们自己的心，以便可以迎接主就是 Krishna 能够让 Krishna能够住在我们的进驻我们的心房。
Right. Lord Jagannath is none different from Lord Sri Krishna, and Lord Sri Krishna is in the heart of every living entity.
主 Jagannath 就是 Krishna 本人，而 Krishna 那是在每一个生物体的心中。
So if we want Lord Krishna to sit in our heart, we have to clean the heart.In order to make it suitable for Krishna to sit there.
因为我们非常渴望 Krishna 能够进驻我们的心房，所以首先我们必须确保我们有一颗干净的心，我们必须把我们的内在就是所有的那些污染就是一扫而空，如此 Krishna 才能够拥有一个非常舒适的地方可以在我们的就是心中的宝座，这边就是能够停留在我们的心中的宝座。
And we don't want to have Krishna sitting in a dirty place.
我们可不希望 Krishna 他是坐在一个就是污秽不洁的地方。
So Lord Chaitanya has already, he's also taught about this in his Shikshastikam, when he said in the very first verse, Cheto Darpanam Marjanam, that we have to clean the heart, clean the mirror of the mind.
在主的八训规中的第一节是他也讲到的 Cheto Darpanam Marjanam,也就是说这个第一件事情我们应该要清楚我们心境上累积的尘垢。
Right. We know in this age, Kali Yuga, our hearts are very dirty.
我们都知道在卡利年代人们的心中有多少的不洁啊。
We have to get rid of all the dirty things in the heart.
我们必须想办法铲除我们心中的不洁。
And Lord Chaitanya has given us the process by which we can clean the heart by chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
主柴坦亚马哈普布教导了我们一种就是试尽我们的心境的一种最好的方法，就是借由吟诵吟唱 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra。
The first result of chanting Hare Krishna is that we begin to clean the heart. We take away the dirty things from the heart.
我们吟诵吟唱至尊主的圣名的出现的第一个效果，就是能够清除我们心境上的这些尘垢不洁。
The same thing is said in the Srimad Bhagavatam in the first canto, second chapter.
在圣严波迦瓦坛第一篇第二章的其中一个师姐也说到
Krishna's there in the second chapter, Sutta Goswami is speaking to the sages of Naimisharanya.
这个是Sutta Goswami 对 Naimisharanya 森林的圣者们所说的一段话。
And he is telling them, Shrinvatam Svakata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana, that by speaking the glories of Lord Krishna and talking about Krishna, it's a pious activity and it cleans the heart.
那这边讲到就是当我们聆听和歌唱 Krishna 的这种信息是一种虔诚的活动，当我们这么做的时候Krishna 会把渴望聆听他信息的奉献者心中那种感官享乐的欲望给清除掉。
Radiantastohi Abhadrani Vidunoti Siritsatam, the material desires which are there in the heartThey're the dirty things in the heart, and they're removed when we start to chant the holy name of Krishna.
当我们开始吟诵吟唱主的圣名的时候，我们心中那种充斥着那种种种的感官享乐的欲望会被逐渐的清除掉。
So if we want to relish the message of Krishna, we have to properly hear and chant.
所以如果我们要能够真正去品味 Krishna 的信息的话，关于 Krishna 的信息的话，那么首先我们必须要懂得如何去正确的去聆听和歌唱 Krishna 的荣耀。
And Krishna will help us to clean the heart because he's already in the heart.
Krishna 他其实早已在我们的心中了当我们如此真诚的歌唱他的圣名的时候，他会帮助我们清洗掉我们心中所有的污染。
Krishna wants to live in our, he wants to continue living in our heart, and so he's helping us to keep the heart clean.
Krishna 早已在我们的心中，而且他想要继续的留住在我们的心中，因此他帮助我们清理我们内在的不洁。
And we have to clean the heart.Just like Lord Chaitanya cleaned the Gundicha temple. If our heart has a lot of things like sand and grains of straw,pieces of straw and weeds and dust in our heart, then we can understand Krishna is not going to be happy sitting there.
我们知道，如果我们的心中，就是满是这些可怕的这些污染，就是不洁，都是一些杂草啊、沙粒啊、稻草、灰尘。污垢，那么想想看 ，Krishna 他怎么可能会开心呢？他怎么会开心？怎么能够开心的留住在我们的心中呢
？All of these things like the sand and straw and the dust, these represent our material desires.
所有内心中的这些，所有的这些灰尘、沙粒。 杂草这些稻草，这些所有的一切都代表着我们心中的这种物质欲望。
So there shouldn't be any material motives behind our devotional service.
这个教导我们，就是在我们从事奉爱服务的时候，我们应该要小心不要保有这种物质的动机。
We shouldn't be trying to do devotional service just to improve our material life.
我们不应该利用奉爱服务想要来改善我们自己的物质生活。
And we're not interested in trying to understand Krishna by our own mental speculation.
我们也不应该凭借我们的心智思辨来了解 Krishna.
These things are against the desire of, this is against the mood of pure devotional service.
所有刚才讲的那些想要改善物质的生存用心智思辨的方法来理解 Krishna, 都是违反纯粹奉爱服务的这种心态。
These things are all called anarthas, or the things which we don't want, and we want to get rid of these anarthas so that Krishna can be comfortable sitting in our heart.
所有刚才讲的那些物质的东西，通通叫做 anartha, 也就是说那些要不得的东西，我们应该想办法铲除这些要不得的东西，以便能够让 Krishna 舒适的住在我们的心中。
So there are different kinds of anarthas, like first of all, material desire. We want to profit, material profit, material gain, or maybe we want adoration or distinction.
有很多种的物质欲望，比方说，我们可能会渴望能够获得物质的利益，有物质的收益，或者是我们希望自己能够很出众。
Another anartha is what is called the weakness of heart. The weakness of heart means that we're not very steady in our spiritual practice.
那还有另外一种 anartha 叫做内心的软弱，也就是说一个人他不是在奉爱服务的就是不是很稳处在奉爱服务的层面上。
Sometimes,
内心的软弱。
Sometimes we chant, sometimes we forget to chant. Sometimes we're very serious, sometimes we're not very serious.
Sometimes what?
We are very serious in doing devotional service and sometimes not.
那有些时候我们念诵，有些时候又不念诵，有些时候很认真，可是有些时候又很懈怠。
And so this is the weakness of heart, and this is another anartha which we want to remove from the heart.
这就是所谓的内心的软弱的一种表征，这是另外一种 anartha 要不得的东西，我们必须要把这样的东西给铲除。
Then there is the anartha of offenses, which may be offenses against devotees, or it may be offenses in chanting the holy name, or it may be offenses against the deity and our worship of the deity.
另外一种 anartha 是叫做冒犯，那这种冒犯有可能是冒犯奉献者，或者是念诵圣名的时候的冒犯，或者是对神像的冒犯。
And then the fourth anartha is where people have a wrong understanding of the philosophy, that they think, you know, ultimately God is impersonal, and where the goal is to merge into the oneness. They have the wrong understanding of the philosophy.
还有第四种 anartha 呢，它指的就是对就是我们奉爱的哲学有错误的认知。比方说有人他错以为就是这个关于就是源头是非人格的这种非人格的概念，想要最后想要跟源头合而为一， 这种泛光的融入泛光的这种追求这样的解脱这种错误的概念。
So the biggest anatta, probably the most prominent anatta, is this desire for material enjoyment, where we think about our own economic development.
那最显著的一种 anatta 就是一种物质欲望，其实就是渴望这种物质的经济的发展繁荣。
We become very attached to endeavoring in the material world to enjoy economic development.
因为对物质存在的这种极度的依恋，就是执着，所以他们很希望能够借由物质的繁荣发展、经济的发展，能够享受物质的生活。
So this desire for material improvement, this is just like straw and sand in the heart, and it just disturbs the heart.
那这些渴望这种改善自己的物质生活的这种欲望，就像是那些稻草、那些沙粒啊，就是占据着我们的心田。
Yeah, endeavoring for material prosperity is not in line with pure devotional service.
那种追求，追名逐利，这种追求这个物质的这种繁荣，它不是，它违反了纯粹奉爱服务的这个方向。
We should endeavor for developing love of Krishna, not just to become rich in the material world.
我们所应该要追求努力的方向，应该是培养对 Krishna 纯粹的奉爱，而不是渴望在这个物质生存中能够变得富有。
So Lord Chaitanya was showing us to clean the heart very carefully, get all the dirt out of it. Then we can really think about developing love for Krishna.
So Guru Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 借由清，就是打扫这个滚地禅庙，他教导我们，我们应该要，就是净化我们的心，就像在打扫滚地禅庙那样的用心。如此，我们才能够开始有这样的希望，可以培养对 Krishna 真正的爱。
But if we're thinking, if our desire is just simply I want to live happily in the material world, this is a material desire. It's not spiritual.
可是，如果我们心里满心满意想的都是如何能够让我的物质生存能够更加的舒适、更加的快乐。
So just like so much dust in the heart, it just covers the heart.
这样子很像是就是浓密的这个灰尘遮蔽住我们的心。
Right, we said we have to clean the mirror of the mind, the heart. Clean the mirror of the heart. It's covered with dust.
所以我们刚才才讲到了我们的心境。这个厚厚的生生世世积累了那么多的尘垢，所以我们应该要清扫我们心中的污染，必须要清扫。
People don't know that for so many lifetimes their hearts have been very dirty.
人们甚至于没有意识到、知觉到自己生生世世心中积累了多少的不洁，甚至于他们不知不觉。
Materialistic people, they're thinking the goal of life is just to enjoy the results of their work.
这个物质生存中，人们呢，总是这样想，想着他们所要过的日子就是好好的享受他们活动的成果。
And they think if they do anything wrong, or if they've done anything wrong, they'll counteract it.By doing some other material activity.
那他们如果他们想要做什么来调整的话，他们可能会用另外一种物质的方式、物质的活动来抵消他们的这种物质的存在的问题。
But this is just like the elephant taking bath.And then coming out and throwing dirt over his body again.
那这种方式呢就很像是大象洗澡，大象到河里洗澡，上岸之后他又在沙堆里打滚，把自己弄得满身脏。
So we shouldn't try to do atonement or counteract our suffering by doing auspicious activities.
所以我们不应该借由一种所谓的这种忏悔这种忏悔的方法，也是一种物质性的一种方法，来抵消我们从事这种果报性活动所带来的结果。那这种方法其实就像大象洗澡一样，永远都没完没了，没有办法彻底的解决我们的问题。所以用这种暂时的忏悔苦行的方法不是我们所推荐的。
We have to, what the only way we can counteract our suffering is by taking up Krishna consciousness, beginning with hearing and chanting.
唯一能够彻底的根除我们物质的痛苦的彻底的方法，就是借由培养 Krishna 意识知觉，以就是聆听和吟诵至尊主的圣名为开始。
Yeah, that chanting and hearing is the beginning of the cleaning of the heart.
因为聆听和吟诵这个Krishna 的荣耀，其实就是清洗我们的心境上的不洁污染的一种程序。
And when our heart is really clean, then we will see Krishna sitting there within the heart, peacefully.
当我们的心一旦被洗净之后，我们就能够就是看到有那样的视域，可以感知到 Krishna， 他就坐在我们的心中，平静的能够感知这所有的一切。
All the other philosophical systems, Mayavadi philosophy, meditation, speculation, it's all like sand in the heart. They simply disturb the heart.
所有其他的方式，像 Mayavadi, 这些非人格神主义者，还有那些采用这种心智思辨的那些人，他们都没有办法达到这个彻底的根除心中的尘垢的这个目的，因为他们还有这么多让他们的心意打扰的东西，因为这都不彻底，他们的心都还会受到这些东西的扰乱。
Now, sometimes we see yogis and gyanis, they begin to chant Hare Krishna, but after some time,They think that now they've chanted enough, now they're already liberated, they think that now they can stop chanting.
我们看到有一些 yogi, 瑜伽师，有一些 gyani, 思辨家，他们刚开始的时候也念诵圣名，主的圣名一段时间，然后他们觉得他们自己已经抵达了所谓解脱的阶段，然后他们就停止了念诵，停止了这个对 Krishna 的服务。这个也是不行的。
They don't understand the goal of life is to chant the holy name and to develop love for God.
他们根本就不知道生命的真正的目标其实就是吟诵吟唱主的圣名，然后培养对主的奉爱之心。
So Lord Chaitanya showed all of us.How to pick up all the dirt and sand and everything and very carefully throw it far away from the temple.
So, Guru Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he 亲自带领的奉献者教导我们如何把这个庙宇里的所有的尘垢、灰尘、杂草、稻草、沙粒全部都铲除，把它扫出庙外。
Yeah, and throw it far away because we don't want it to come back again.
而且要远远的，就是把他们扫离这个庙里，要把他们就是彻底的从庙里清除出去，而且要很远很远，离庙很远。
Just
不要让这些脏的东西再回来了。
Just like sometimes we come to Krishna consciousness and we're trying to give up material desires. And for some time we're successful, but then again the material desires come back in the heart.
这个就像我们培养 Krishna 意识知觉，有些时候我们以为自己呢已经没有什么物质欲望了，可是事实上，并不是如此。可能过了不久的一段时间，可能受到了什么样的刺激跟诱惑，这些欲望，它又在这个就在燃起了，他们就卷土重来了。
So the material these dirty things in the heart.Can come in subtle ways. It may come also that we start finding fault with others unnecessarily.
那内心的这些不洁这些尘垢呢，有些时候会以一种非常精细的方式来向我们展现。比方说，我们可能会有这种挑别人毛病的这种倾向。
And sometimes it's because we have envy, we're feeling some jealousy of other people.
有些时候我们也会有妒忌其他人的这种倾向。
And sometimes the desire within our own heart for position and for respect.
有些时候我们心中还会有那种对那种名望地位渴求别人的尊重的这种需求，这种杂草。
And sometimes we just want to be popular. We want that people, everybody should like us. We don't like to criticize anybody. We just want people to say, oh, he's very good. Oh, he's very nice. So we just want to be popular. This is also a material desire.
还有另外一种物质欲望。就是我们会很渴望自己能够非常受人欢迎希望身边的人都能够喜欢我们，其实这也是一种物质欲望的展现。
And sometimes people want to imitate great devotees like Haridas. They want, you know, Haridas used to sit in all on his own, he'd go in a cave and sit and chant. So sometimes we say, I just want to sit and chant, andWe just want to, we want to get name that we are great devotees. We just chant.
对，有些时候有些人心中有这样的污染，他们想要模仿那些伟大的奉献者，比方说像 Haridas Thakur 这样子就是躲到山洞里面，就在那边坐着念诵圣名。那他们这么做，其实只是一种模仿。装模作样，根本没有实质的奉爱之心。他们心里想着的都是对名望的渴求。
And new devotees, they will certainly also have problem with material desires, and usually that desire will come in the desire for money and relationships with the other sex.
那一些新的奉献者可能比较容易受到这种比较粗糙的这种。物质欲望的打扰比方说他们会很希望能够就是赚钱也希望能够跟异性保有那样的关系。
And this way the heart becomes filled with dirty things and the heart becomes hard, just like a materialist.
那如此呢，那这样的心就会充斥着各种的污染，各种的垃圾脏东西，那让自己的心变得很焦灼。
And sometimes you get devotees who come, they want to get a big position, they want to be known as a great devotee.
那有些时候奉献者们有些人他们会非常的渴望自己的地位能够受到人们的这种赞赏。他们会很渴望这个名望地位。
Yeah, you get people who come, they join the movement, and then they work their way up, and they get into management, and then they become in charge of a temple, and then they become in charge of a whole area, and then before that, after that, then they say that they're an incarnation, that they become an avatar.
这种渴望别人的认同，想要获得这种高的权势地位的这种心态。 可能刚开始的时候、加入运动，他们会比较渴望能够从事这种管理的、这种职务、管一个小地方、将来慢慢的管一个庙，甚至于后来管整个区域，后来更严重，可能觉得自己都是神的化身了。所以这个是慢慢的一直扩大，一直长养自己这种对这种居民的、这种眷恋渴望，这种杂草。
嗯。And if people are envious of other people, then this is very bad because this stops the preaching of Krishna consciousness.
嗯，还有一种就是嫉妒的倾向。那这种嫉妒的这种要不得的东西，它会让人就是停止传教。
So preaching work is how we give it's our welfare activities for the benefit of others.
传教事实上是对众生的最大的福祉，是这给众生这种真正的福祉的一种活动。
So people who don't know about the benefit of devotional service, they get educated by our preaching.
嗯，那些不了解我们的传教活动的真正的意义，对世界所带来的巨大的福祉的人。他们会因为我们的传教活动而变得焦虑不安。
But if we,
他们会对我，嗯。
If we stop the preaching, then there's no benefit. It becomes mundane. There's no spiritual activity.
那他们会就是逐渐的就放弃这种就是反对这个传教的活动。那他们如果一旦不从事传扬Krishna 一世知觉的这样的活动的话，他们当然他们所从事的一定是回到所谓的世俗的活动。
So Lord Chaitanya, remember he cleaned the temple not just once, he cleaned it twice, and the second time he cleaned it more thoroughly.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他带领奉献者打扫。滚地场庙，他不是只有清理一次，他清理了两次。这第二次是更加仔细的处理更细微的这种打扫。
So he did all this just to show us how to get rid of all the blocks, all the things, the obstacles on our path of devotion.
他这么做是为了向我们展示，如何彻底的清除我们在奉爱道路上的。
Right, he cleaned the temple. When the marble is very clean, the marble has a nice cooling effect. So the same way when our heart is clean, then it's also cool.
So, 主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他在打扫这个滚地床庙的时候，他让整个庙里的大理石都呈现出这样的这种清凉。这种效果，那么同样的，如果我们的心能够打扫干净的话，同样我们的心也会有被抚慰这种清凉的这种觉受。
So even though we get rid of all the gross things, still there's subtle things there in the form of desires, which have to be also removed.
所以尽管我们就是铲除了那些粗糙的、容易被辨识的污染，我们还是要非常的小心翼翼检视我们的内在的那种细微的那种污染。
Right.
这个是要很小心的。
And so these things, they're like some kind of spot on the clean cloth.
这种内心这种精微的这种欲望呢？就很像是洁白无瑕的布上面的一个污点。
So when the heart is nice and clean, then we can invite Krishna to sit there peacefully.
当我们的心被清理干净的时候，那么我们就能够看见在我们进驻我们心中的主 Krishna.
So just like Lord Chaitanya taught the devotees by his example,We also have to teach others by our example.
就像主柴坦亚马哈帕布他以身作则，同样的我们也是要以身作则来教导其他的人怎么去清理自己心中的污染。
This cleaning of the heart is like the process of anartha nivritti, removing the unwanted desires from the heart.
那么这种洗净清扫的这个过程呢，其实就像是就是我们的这个奉爱服务里面的一个的其中那个 anartha nivritti， 也就是说清理清扫我们心中所有的不洁要不得的东西的这个步骤。
So there was a couple of interesting events took place while Lord Chaitanya was cleaning the temple. We will describe.
那接着我们来讲述主柴坦亚马哈帕布在打扫滚地床庙的时候发生的几件有趣的事件。
One devotee came with a bucket of water and he poured the water on the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then he took that water which had washed the feet of Lord Chaitanya and he drank that water.
有一位奉献者呢，他拿了一桶的水，然后把水泼在主柴坦亚马哈帕布的莲花足，然后他喝饮从他的莲花足就是流淌下来的水。
So Lord Chaitanya told the senior devotee who was helping him in charge of the cleaning of the temple. Lord Chaitanya complained about this man. He said he should not have done this because this is a temple and it's wrong to accept worship and to have your feet washed in front of the deity.
这个时候主柴坦亚马哈帕布就把资深的一个奉献者，就是那个帮助他带领奉献者一起打扫这个庙宇的奉献者给叫来，他告诉他说刚才这位奉献者就是喝饮主柴坦亚马哈帕布的浊煮水的这个奉献者，他说他这么做是不对的，不应该在这个神像的面前就是来沐浴他的这个莲花足，这么做是不对的。
Right, and devotee will not accept worship in front of the deities in front in or in the temple room. So Lord,
因为奉献者不应该在庙堂里接受其他的人，就是其他的人对他的崇拜，这是不对的，这是一种冒犯。
Of course, Lord Chaitanya is Krishna himself.But he's playing the part of a devotee, so he didn't want to be disturbed as a devotee. But this person did not respect this, and he took advantage to wash the feet of Lord Chaitanya.
尽管卢柴坦亚马哈帕布他就是 Krishna 本人，但是他扮演着的是奉献者的角色，因此他就是要纠正这种状况，就是说他不希望奉献者就是在神像面前对他做这样的事情，利用这个机会然后就是沐浴他的这个莲花足。
So Lord Chaitanya had that person put out of the temple.
所以主柴坦亚马哈帕布就命令这个奉献者把这一位就是做了这个冒犯，就是喝饮他的浊煮水的这个奉献者，把他赶了出去。
And then another pastime which took place was, while they were cleaning the temple, they were all chanting the holy name. They would bring water and pour the water. They would chant Krishna, Krishna, and they would sweep and they would chant Krishna, Krishna. So there was always chanting going on.
在整个打扫这个神庙的过程中。奉献者们无论是在用扫帚打扫，还是在提着水，他们每一个人在他们干活的时候，都同时一直不断地吟诵主的圣名 Krishna Krishna， 从来都不间断。
And people were rushing. They'd bring the water and they'd pour the water, and then they'd have to rush back to bring more water. so people were rushing, and sometimes they would bump into each other and they'd break the pots.
那这些奉献者们匆匆忙忙的来回的去取水，然后水用光了又再去取水，然后他们就在这个匆忙之中，有些时候会不小心互相的碰撞，就把这个水罐给打碎了。
So when they finished cleaning, then they had a big kirtan. And Lord Chaitanya, he asked the son of Advaita Acharya to dance and chant.
然后在他们完成了这个滚地场庙的这个清扫之后，他们就开始举办这个盛大的 kirtan. 他就要求 Advaita Acharya 的儿子起来舞蹈。
Actually, Advaita Acharya has 6 sons, but 3 are devotees and 3 are not.
Advaita Acharya, 他总共有六个儿子，其中三个是奉献者，另外三个不是。
So Lord Chaitanya requested this one young devotee, who was one of the sons of Advaita Acharya, he requested him, you please chant. So the boy's name was Gopal, and he began to dance and chant. And he was dancing and chanting, but then suddenly he fainted and he fell unconscious.
那 Advaita Acharya 的这个儿子，这个小儿子，他的名字就叫 Gopal。那主宰天涯 Mahaprabhu 就邀请他起来唱诵圣名起来舞蹈，然后他就起来欢天喜地的，就是起舞着。可是就在这片这个欢欣雀跃的氛围中，突然间他就昏了过去，失去了知觉。
So Advaita Acharya was very worried, and he came and he picked up his son, but he saw his son was not breathing at all.
这个时候 ，Advaita Acharya 他就看到他儿子昏倒在地，他立刻就把他抱了起来。可是他感受到这个儿子好像没有了呼吸。
So they were all very worried. All the devotees were chanting the holy name of Lord Nrisimhadev. They were all very worried. And then Lord Chaitanya came and he put his hand on the chest of Gopal and he spoke, Gopal, get up and chant the holy name.
然后所有的人都非常的担心。那这个时候就是所有的人都开始高唱就是主女神哈的祈祷，然后就是不断的唱诵祈求保护这个 Gopal。 那但是他还是没有醒过来，所以这个时候主宰他呀 Mahaprabhu 他就过来，就是拍一拍就是 Gopal， 就告诉他，你起来吧，你起来唱诵圣名吧。
And immediately the child came back to consciousness and stood up and began to chant the holy name.
这个时候，这个孩子 Gopal， 他立刻就起来了，立刻就站了起来，开始唱诵主的圣名。
So this is some of the pastimes which took place, which are described in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in relation to the cleansing of the Gundicha temple.
刚才这几个小故事。是这个逍遥时光滚地场 Marjana 就是清打扫滚地场庙的逍遥时光中的几个小故事。
So we will stop here and we will ask if there's any questions from anybody.
我们今天的讲课就先到这里，我们现在来看看奉献者们有没有什么问题。Okay, the first question is from Zhen Zhen. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您甜美的莲花族，顶拜甜美的翻译主持人，顶拜所有的奉献者。想请问 Guru Dev, 我如何找到我的服务呢？我不知道我能够做什么，要做什么。感恩 Guru Dev.
Well,we learn from this pastime that what we have to do, we have to clean our own heart.
我们从这个逍遥时光，我们可以学习到， 我们该做什么呢？首先我们应该要先就是 清扫我们 的心。
Lord Krishna is sitting in our heart, but our heart's dirty. Within our heart, there's so much contamination, material desires.
主 Krishna, 他就坐落在我们的心中，可是我们的心现在这么脏，我们真的需要好好的清理。
So we have to clean the heart carefully, very carefully, as shown by Lord Chaitanya, how he cleaned the temple of Gundicha.
所以我们必须要小心翼翼地拭净我们的心，心中的尘垢，就像主柴坦扬马哈帕布他以身作则示范给我们看的，他是如何小心翼翼地清理这个滚地床庙。
So if we can make our heart nice and clean, that will be very pleasing to Lord Krishna.
一旦我们的心被洗净，那么我们 就能够很好的取悦至尊主。
And the process to clean the heart, we said by chanting the holy name, and by also studying the books like the Bhagavad Gita, and associating with devotees.
那这个清理我们的心中的尘垢的方法呢，就是我们这个奉爱服务的程序中，我们借由吟诵吟唱至尊主的圣名，我们研习Srila Prabhupada 的书，像《古家梵歌》，我们需要跟奉献者联谊。
When the heart becomes nice and clean, then Krishna will give us direction from the heart.What we need to do, to how we can serve him.
一旦我们的心中变得干干净净的时候，那么 Krishna 他就能够直接的在我们的心中可以对我们下命令，让指导我们，让我们知道我们该怎么做，怎么去服务他。
But.You have to become steady in the practice of the devotional principles.
但是首先，要必须要先练习，奉爱服务的这些规范原则，这些原则性的东西都必须要去遵守。
In the beginning, we have many material desires, and gradually these material desires will be purified through devotional service.
我们的心中生生世世以来真的堆垒了太多太多的物质的欲望了，我们必须要借由奉爱服务的程序好好的一步一步的清理所有的这些污染，这些欲望。
So you have to be patient and you have to continue to chant and hear and be steady in your practice.
所以你必须要非常非常的有耐心，继续的吟诵吟唱聆听至尊主的圣名，做好服务，让自己的奉爱服务奉爱的生活越来越稳定，
Lord Chaitanya,
越来越强壮。
Lord Chaitanya cleans the Gundicha temple one day in the year, we have to clean the heart every day.
主柴坦亚马哈帕布他是在一年中的一天去打扫滚地床庙，而我们呢必须日复一日每一天都要扫净我们的心中的尘垢。
Krishna's living in our heart and we have to make the heart a nice place for him to sit.
Krishna 他就在我们的心中，所以我们一定要总是确保给 Krishna 提供一个最纯净美好的环境。
Okay, is there another question?
Yes. Gita Govinda Mataji, Hare Krishna, 请接受我卑微的礼拜 Guru Maharaj, 我还没纯粹，不能理解纯粹奉献者内心没有物质欲望的感受，所以会害怕没有物质欲望后有生存的问题，就是说他没有物质欲望之后， 他会担心有生存的问题，
生存，
还有怕生存，就是 how to survive。She is afraid, you know, since we get rid of the material desire, we no more material benefit. So how can we survive? 还有怕没有钱做布施去胜利。She's also afraid she, you know, without money, she cannot, you know, give charity and also go to the holy town.
Well, at this time, nobody's able to go to the holy town.Whether you have money or not.
这现在不管有钱没有钱也都去不了圣地，就先不用担心，因为现在整个世界的状况动弹不得。
Now, you have to understand, we cannot be completely without desire, but we have to desire in relation to Krishna.
我们必须要了解要去除欲望基本上是不可能的，但是我们可以转化我们的欲望，我们把它转化为渴望跟 Krishna 建立关系的这种欲望。
Now for the worship of Krishna, you have to have some things to offer, you have to cook for Krishna, you have to have food, you have to have a place to stay, you have to have a home for Krishna.You cannot think you don't have any desire, but we have to desire what is necessary for our Krishna consciousness.
在我们培养 Krishna 意识知觉的过程中，我们还是保有这个欲望，只是不是世俗的物质的欲望。比方说，我们要崇拜 Krishna， 我们要给 Krishna 供奉各种东西，我们要为 Krishna 做饭。我们要让 Krishna 有地方待，我们也要有一个地方才能够维持下去，为 Krishna 做服务。所以这也都是欲望，只是这个欲望已经没有自我的，这不是自我的需求的欲望，而是服务 Krishna 的欲望。
Just like we have a material body, but our material body is being used in the service of Krishna.So the material body is becoming spiritualized by connection to service of Krishna.
就像我们现在也是有物质身体啊，对。可是物质身体，如果我们能够用来为 Krishna 做服务的话，那么我们的物质身体等于就被灵性化了，它反而成了我们跟 Krishna 连接的工具。
And remember, Krishna's in your heart. So you have to take care of Krishna, and you have to take care of Krishna's living, Krishna's home. He's made a home there in your heart. So you have to keep that home healthy. You have to keep the heart healthy. You have to keep the body strong and fit. You have to keep it nice and clean, and you have to make it a suitable place for Lord Krishna to reside.
Krishna.就在我们每个人的心中，所以我们要好好的照顾 Krishna 的家，我们的心就是 Krishna 的家，所以我们要让我们的心非常的健康，非常的光明，让我们的身体也要非常的强壮，洁净，就是适合让 Krishna 来使用。
So, don't neglect the needs of the body.And think it's all material, it's in relation to your devotional service.
So, 千万不要因为我们学习这个就以为可以，我们可以忽略我们的身体，我们的心，不是的，我们不应该忽略，我们反而应该要好好的来照顾这个 Krishna 的财产，把它用来为 Krishna 做服务，来让他们成为为 Krishna 做服务的好工具，来取悦 Krishna.
And Krishna will arrange for your material sustenance. Krishna will provide. Krishna takes care of all his devotees.
而且 Krishna, 他总是照顾着他的奉献者。当我们做好了我们的本分之后， Krishna 自然他就会为我们安排所有的一切，包括物质的方方面面。
So don't worry. Krishna's taking care of you, Krishna's protecting you, Krishna's maintaining you.
所以, 请不要担心, Krishna 始终保护着你, Krishna 始终维系着你, Krishna 始终提供着所有的一切。
But this doesn't mean you do nothing. You have to do your part. You have to be the instrument in the service of Krishna.
但是这并不意味着你就就是在那里什么都不做，你必须要还是要履行你的职责，然后如此你才能够成为Krishna 的工具。
No, Krishna told Arjuna, "Remember me," but he also told Arjuna, "You have to fight. You have to do your duty."
就像在《国家梵歌》中 ，Krishna 告诉 Arjuna, 你要时时意念着我，想着我，同时履行你作战的职责。所以，虽然我们想着 Krishna， 但是我们还是要去履行我们自己的职责。
Yes, thank you. Okay, next question.
Luna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and all the devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. How should we celebrate Radha Yatra at home? 这个Luna 的问题是，他说 Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj 以及所有的奉献者，请接受我谦卑的礼拜。我们要如何在家中庆祝盘车节呢？
I should explain this lady. Yuna is a lady living in the far east of Russia in a remote town where there's no devotees.
这位奉献者他是住在这个苏联一个很偏远的城镇的一个奉献者。
And we celebrate Radha Yatra at home. You can observe the. Try to log on the internet, and you'll probably find it's being broadcast on the internet.
那就是可以就是在家中就是用那个就是网际网路啊，就是连上这个就是弹车节的这种直播。
And there are some parts of the world where they're not allowed to go out into the public to have Radha Yatra, so they will just simply do it inside the temple room. So you can do Radha Yatra in your own home if you want. If you have a little Jagannath, you can have a little procession and you can go around your room and sing and dance Hare Krishna.
在这个世界上，有些地方他们是没有办法，在公众，在就是，在公众举行这个所谓的弹车节的游车的，因此，像这种情况，可以在自己家中的庙堂里，神像房里，那么如果你有这个小弹车的话，你就可以自己推着你自己的弹车，在自己的家中，就是游行，然后并且就是歌唱就是舞蹈，就是来荣耀这个主 Jagannath。
You simply have the mood of bringing Krishna to the holy dham, to Vrindavan, bringing Krishna from his abode in his palace at Jagannath Puri and bringing him to Gundicha.
只要就是心中能够怀有这样的一种情感和理解心态，就是知道就是把就是你推着这个弹车是让这个主 Jagannath 就是从这个 Jagannath 庙然后到了Gundicha庙就像是从圣地也是像圣地然后到了这个 Vrindavan 一样的。
So you can, also read the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the descriptions of Lord Chaitanya during Radha Yatra.
So
even though we're not physically able to take part, we can take part mentally in Rath Yatra.
如果我们没有办法亲身的参加这个 Radha Yatra, 我们可以在心中冥想这个 Radha Yatra.
You simply read that chapter, chapter number 13 about the Rath Yatra, and you read about Lord Chaitanya, how he's dancing and how they're all chanting.And the pastimes which take place there.
可以来阅读，奉献者们可以阅读《永恒的柴太阳经》中篇逍遥 Madhya Lila 的第四十三章，就是主柴太阳 Mahaprabhu 在坎车节的舞蹈。我们可以看到主柴太阳 Mahaprabhu 是如何在主 Jagannath 的面前如何的就是唱诵舞蹈。
Yes.Okay, any other question?
Okay, let me check. Oh, okay. Chen Hua Wei, Ding Bai, 感谢 Guru Maharaj 精彩的内容和 Madhaji 的翻译。有个故事有关冒犯议题极其精微。Rupa Goswami 有一次在冥想Radha 和 Krishna 的逍遥时光时，由于内心的喜悦而脸部露出了微笑。此时刚好来了一位跛脚的 Brahmana， 这位 Brahmana 感受到冒犯而生气了，于是跑去找 Sanatan Goswami 去讲这件事。想请问 Maharaj 为何这样也算冒犯，谢谢您。Maharaj, do you understand the Chinese?
Yeah. Do you want? So, the question is about the Brahmana felt offended because Rupa Goswami was laughing. Rupa Goswami was meditating on the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.And something amusing happened in Rupa Goswami's meditation on the pastimes of Radha and Krishna. It caused Rupa Goswami to laugh, and the Brahmana thought that the Rupa Goswami was laughing at him. Because
yes, yes.
So the Brahmana went to Sanatana Goswami and complained that Rupa Goswami had offended him. Right?
Yes, correct, exactly.So Maharaj, because this, you completely understand the question, so I don't have to translate.
So her question is, she wants to know about, was Rupa Goswami an offender?
Yes, she would like to know how could it be a kind of offense?
Yes, the Brahmana took offense, and they say that because of the Brahmana taking offense, Rupa Goswami was not able to continue his meditation on the pastimes of Radha and Krishna. And then he wondered what he'd done wrong, and then he thought about maybe this Brahmana had taken some offense against him.
当时 Rupa Goswami 正在冥想着就是 Radha 跟 Krishna 的逍遥时光，但是后来他的冥想怎么突然就中断了，然后因此他就想说这位跛脚的婆罗门刚好经过嘛，他在想说有可能是他冒犯了这位婆罗门啊。那因为确实当时他在笑的时候，他在这种喜悦之中喜不自禁地笑了起来，那这个跛脚的婆罗门他真的是以为他在笑他，所以他就生气了，这婆罗门生气了，那因为他真的生气了，所以也因此这个 Rupa Goswami 的冥想也就被中断了，所以他也有感受到怎么会突然中断，这个事情一定有问题，所以他就想是不是他
So, of course, there was no real offense on the part of Rupa Goswami, but because the Brahmana felt offended, so it influenced Rupa Goswami's meditation.
事实上, Rupa Goswami 并没有真的做了什么冒犯, 但是由于这个婆罗门, 他真的是, 他真的就觉得自己是被冒犯了, 所以由于他觉得自己被冒犯了, 因此还是会有影响力的, 就打断了这个Rupa Goswami的冥想。
And Rupa Goswami explained to the Brahmana why he was laughing, and when the Brahmana heard the explanation, then the Brahmana accepted it. And Rupa Goswami offered his obeisances, and the Brahmana accepted, and he offered obeisances, and in this way, everything was resolved.
后来这个Rupa Goswami 就告诉这个跛脚的婆罗门向他解释的他在冥想的时候所感受的东西，所以。 就让这个婆罗门了解了为什么他会在冥想中会笑，所以后来这个婆罗门就了解了，哦，原来他根本就不是在笑他跛脚，他就了解了。因此，这个Rupa Goswami 也向这个婆罗门顶拜，祈求他的原谅，他不是有意的笑他的，他并没有在笑他，但是也请求他的理解，向他顶拜。而这个婆罗门了解真相之后，也向他向 Rupa Goswami 顶拜。
So the instruction is how we have to be very careful in dealing with other devotees and sensitive to other people.
那这个事件呢，这个逍遥呢，也告诉我们，当我们在面对对待其他的奉献者的时候，我们要非常的小心，非常的敏感，不要去冒犯奉献者。
Okay.
Yes. The next one is Annie. 顶拜 Guru 甜美的莲花族，顶拜翻译 Mataji， 请 Guru 介绍一下如何进行这个月开始苦行戒食绿叶菜。我还从来没有试过。感恩 Guru 和翻译 Hari Krishna.
Yes. We have to, yeah. She's asking about fasting, that we're going to begin the Chaturmasya, the 4 months of austerity, and we're supposed to fast from green leafy vegetables. So she never did this before, and she wants to know what she has to fast from.
Yes, exactly.
So, this is a little bit not very clear, but generally, people say you should not eat saag. Saag means a spinach, which is a vegetable which Lord Chaitanya was very fond of. And we're not supposed to take that vegetable because in the rainy season, there are many insects on that vegetable. And you know, now is the first month, 4 months of Chaturmasya is the beginning of the rainy season. So there are many insects on this vegetable. So we're not supposed to eat the green spinach, the leafy vegetables during that time.
那事实上这个四月苦行的这条戒律，也有些地方没有很清楚，但是基本上他们就是说不吃这种萨克，也就是说菠菜这种绿叶菜，因为在这个四月苦行的期间，正好是印度的雨季，在雨季的期间会有很多的虫子。 就是这个绿叶的蔬菜，这个菠菜会长特别多的虫子，所以是不吃的。还有就是主采太阳 Mahaprabhu 他也特别喜欢吃这个绿色的这个菠菜。So
there are many other vegetables. I mean, you can continue to take cabbage. Cabbage is baitai, and you can take that. You can also take all the other vegetables. You know, they're just saying don't eat these. This particular green leafy vegetable.
你还是可以吃其他的蔬菜的，比方说，这种白菜呀，白菜 ，Maharaj cabbage 是高丽菜哦，白菜，白菜，还有其他的这个蔬菜，其他的种类的蔬菜是没有问题的，但是主要的就是不吃这种菠菜。
It's only for 1 month, it's not a great austerity.
那因为就是
这个也四月的苦行，这个不算是很大的苦行。
And just for 1 month, we say don't eat green leafy vegetables.
就一个月不能吃这种绿色的这个菠菜。
But you can eat all the other vegetables, you know, 南瓜、苦瓜、土豆。So many other vegetables are there, you can manage, not difficult.
So Maharaj, you mean even including other green leaves we don't take?
No, you can take.
Or just suck?
Usually,
spinach.
Just the spinach we don't take.
Okay, okay. 只不吃菠菜，其他的很还有那么多的蔬菜可以吃啊，苦瓜、土豆，那些就是马铃薯。台湾说马铃薯，中国说土豆，这样子，其他那么多的蔬菜都可以吃，那只有一个月不能吃菠菜而已，这不算什么苦行。
Yeah, okay. Any other?
Okay.
还有问题吗？没有。
有，还有一个露露，礼拜咕噜的莲花族有两个问题。第一个问题是，请问我们如何检视自己内心的不洁被清理到什么程度？这是第一个问题。第二个问题是，有时候我们发现自己或许清理了某种不洁，但是有时候这种不洁可能又会卷土重来。我们在这条道路上如何稳定的进步呢？因为再次的堕落似乎是非常容易的事。Maharaj, do you understand?
No, I didn't get it all.
Okay, the first question is that he would like to know how do we know, you know, to what extent our heart is cleansed?
Yes, that's a good question. Thank you for asking that, Mataji.
感谢问这个问题，这是一个很好的问题。
这
第一个问题，我们一个一个来，先讲第一个。
You can understand how much your heart is cleansed by how you're becoming free from the material desires.
我们可以借由来检查我们自己有多大的程度免除了物质欲望，来了解自己的心已经清理到什么程度了。
And if our heart is actually becoming clean, then we'll have more attraction to chanting the holy name.
而我们的心越是干净，我们就越受吟诵吟唱主的圣灵的吸引。
And you're more eager to hear about Krishna and to talk about Krishna.
我们会更热切的渴望去聆听，以及谈论主的荣耀。
So this is really the test of how much we have cleansed the heart, that we've got more taste.And we're taking more pleasure in the chanting and hearing about Krishna.
所以检视我们内心到底被就是内心的不洁被清理到什么程度的一个指标，就是我们的灵性品味。当我们培养了越多的培养了对聆听和歌颂 Krishna 的这种品味，这种喜悦更加的长养的时候。也就是我们的品味越加的长养的时候，意味着我们的内心就越洁净。
Yes. And the second question?
The second question. Sometimes, we found we has cleansed a certain kind of anartha, but sometimes such kind of anartha will come back. Yeah. So how can we, you know, make steady progress on the bhakti path, because you know we fall down again. It seems to be very easy for us to fall down again.
Yes, you're very correct in your analysis. That the material desires, material desires may seem to go and then they come back again.We have to go deep to pull out the roots of material desires.
是的，物质欲望真的很可怕，他们来来去去的，就这样子，
以为不见了，可是又再来，所以意味着我们要深度的、深度的去根除这种根深蒂固的这种欲望，
and、
我们要很深度的去铲除它。
In order to get all the material desires out of the heart, we have to improve the quality of our devotional service.
为了要铲除这些要不得的这些物质的欲望呢，很重要的是我们必须要让我们的奉爱服务的品质变得更加的强壮，更加的好。
Yeah, we have to really improve the quality of how we hear and chant. We have to chant with great attention and we have to hear very carefully.
我们必须好好的来改善我们的聆听以及吟诵的这种品质，我们要非常的仔细的专注的聆听，我们必须要很小心的聆听，很专注的来吟诵。
These material desires have come back because we haven't because the quality of our devotional service is not very goodAnd therefore, this room, therefore, the material desires are able to grow up again.
正因为我们奉爱服务的品质还没有做到很完美，还不够好，所以才会留给这个物质欲望有缝隙、有空间，可以再重新，就是再长养出这些，再回来。
We have to recognize the weed, just like when we are growing.The plants, we have to recognize what is the real plant of devotion and distinguish it from the weeds of material desires. And then we have to pull out these weeds of material desires.
所以我们在就是浇灌我们这个奉爱的幼苗的时候，我们从事这些奉爱服务，我们要也要非常非常的小心，会有那些杂草。野草也会长出来，我们要小心翼翼的来照顾，注意我们这个奉爱幼苗的成长，不要被这个野草给淹没了。
So it's all based on the quality of our hearing and chanting.
所以就是在于如果我们的吟诵、我们的聆听，是不是能够做到很好的品质？如果我们的品质很好，我们就不会。在滋生出这样的物质欲望。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Yes?
The next one, 小鱼。
小鱼。
Hare Krishna, 明白 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, 我们这么多不解，为什么总是觉得自己做得很好，好像都感觉不到自己心中的不解呢？ Hare Krishna.Maharaj, Xiaoyu's question is that, you know, our heart is full of anartha, dirty things, but how come we always failed, we are doing well. We are free from the anartha. It seems that we don't feel our anartha in the heart.
Yes, because often we're not aware of the anarthas. That's why we have to hear about these things. We have to understand that they're present.
是啊，我们经常就是不知不觉都没有知觉到自己心中有那么多的不解。这就是为什么我们应该要培养这样的知识，要来理解有所谓心中的不解这一回事。
Therefore, Lord Chaitanya performed this program of cleaning the Gundicha temple to instruct all of us how we have to clean the heart.
所以主柴坦亚马尔帕布他才会上演这样的逍遥时光来教导我们，我们每一个人都应该要洗净我们心中的尘垢。
Maya is very careful, very cunning.She deceives us. We are thinking, I'm a good devotee.
Maya 她永远是对我们虎视眈眈的，她是那么的狡猾，她总是让我们有这种错误的，有这种错觉，以为我们自己还很不错，是个不错的奉献者。
We have to understand Maya is standing everywhere around us. We have to see Maya everywhere. We have to be on guard against Maya constantly.
我们必须时时小心翼翼地提防这个 Maya， 她真的是无所不在，随时对我们真的是虎视眈眈，随时想趁机而入。
And as soon as you start to think I'm a good devotee, that's Maya.
一旦我们以为自己还是个不错的奉献者的时候，我们已经陷入了 Maya 的罗网。
So you should be aware in future. Next time you're thinking I'm good, I'm okay, this is the Maya.
所以以后呢，你要特别的小心。当自己觉得自己很不错的时候，就知道说，哦，原来我已经被玛雅给网罗了，我已经陷溺了。
Yes.
Yes, Maharaj. The next question is Sati Mataji. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有的奉献者，请 Guru 再详细讲述如何清除内心的软弱，强大的物质能量难以克服。让我们不能恒常的服务，总是波荡。Okay, my obeisances to Guru Maharaj and all the devotees. Maharaj, do you understand Sati Mataji's question?
It's how to clean the heart of the material. What?
He would like you to. Would you please elaborate how to, you know, free from the weakness of the heart, especially the weakness of the heart.Because the powerful material energy is really difficult to overcome, and you know, prevent us from to serve constantly. We are always influenced by the ups and downs of the, you know, mind's ups and downs.
Yes. So the process is, again, devotional service.You have to improve the quality of your hearing and chanting. The solution to all the problems is in devotional service.
我们再强调一次，所有的解答都在奉爱服务之中。我们必须要非常的专注于去改善我们奉爱服务的品质。我们应该要改善我们聆听和念诵的品质。
So it's very good if a devotee can have a nice, has good association, regular association. You stay together with other devotees, then it's very good for your Krishna consciousness.
如果奉献者们能够定期的联谊聚会的话，那么对奉献者来讲，真是一件非常好的事情。非常的重要，非常有帮助。
You go back to your home and your griha with your family and they're not devotees. Of course, it's going to be very difficult for you to be steady in your Krishna consciousness.
如果你回到家中跟家人在一起，家人如果都不是奉献者的话，事实上就会比较难以保持这样的 Krishna 意识知觉，很难就是在。保持这种稳定的这种奉爱服务，这种奉爱服务的品质。
But if you want to be steady, and you want to avoid these weaknesses of the heart, you have to have strong association. You have to be very strict with yourself and keep up as a very steady program.
可是如果你希望自己能够有恒常稳定的这种奉爱服务的这种状态态度的话。能够超越自己内心的软弱的话，我们必须要恒常跟奉献者联谊，而且要对自己要有很严格的要求，要求自己能够有很好的这个灵性的这个服务的品质。
Do you want to? We have to be really strict with ourselves. You have to control the mind. You have to be very determined not to give in to the weakness of the mind.
嗯，我们必须要律己慎言，我们必须要小心翼翼的控制我们的心意，哦，不要随波逐流，要非常坚定的，就是不要受到这个，就是这种内心的软弱的这种打扰。
The mind is saying, "Oh, you're a good devotee. You're doing nice service. You don't need to be so serious. You can take a few days off."
嗯，我们的心意可能会到对我们说，就是你已经是一个很好的奉献者。你看，你做了那么好的服务，那啊，你不用这么认真的啦。你已经做得够好了，你可以休息一天啦。我们的心意总是对我们说出这样的话，这个玛雅。
So we have to really want to avoid these shortcomings and avoid these failures. We have to be really strict. And if you have strong association, then it's very helpful. If you can live in the community of devotees, then it's very helpful.
所以我们要经常的保持跟奉献者的联谊，因为奉献者的联谊跟这些有力量的人在一起，会让我们保有这样的力量，也比较能够看见自己的问题。
Even you cannot live in the community, at least if you can live near to the center, and then every morning you could be going to the temple and attending the morning program.
如果我们没有办法始终跟奉献者保持联谊的话，我们也可以如果是离庙比较近的人，也可以去参加庙里的活动，早晨的庙里早晨的这些活动来帮助自己。
But Srila Prabhupada never lived in the temple, and Srila Prabhupada was always able to keep up his Krishna consciousness.
Srila Prabhupada, 他并没有住在庙里，但是他总是能够让自己保持这个 Krishna 知觉意识。
Even though his family were not really strict devotees, but it didn't stop him. He was determined, he was serious in practicing Krishna consciousness.
Srila Prabhupada 的家人，尽管他们不是像 Srila Prabhupada 这样子如此进步的这个纯粹的奉献者，但是他们也没有办法就是去打扰 Srila Prabhupada， 因为 Srila Prabhupada 他是非常的严格的，就是按照奉爱服务的规范守着这么做，所以他的家人也影响不了他，对他起不了任何的作用，因为他有巨大的这种
So we should understand it's definitely possible to be Krishna conscious. We just have to be really determined that we're going to do it.
我们所欠缺的就是巨大的决心，我们坚定的决心，我们欠缺坚定的决心。所以 Krishna 意识知觉并不是真的那么的困难，问题是我们没有足够的决心、定力。
So Prabhupada would often say, we're trying, we're practicing. We're not yet Vaishnavas, we're trying to become Vaishnavas. We're practicing.
是的 Prabhupada, 他说其实我们都在尝试，我们在努力，我们在练习。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna explained about controlling the mind, and practicing meditation, and Arjuna said he couldn't do it because his mind was too restless and unsteady. But Krishna said it's possible by constant practice and detachment.
那在薄伽梵歌中，就是Arjuna 告诉 Krishna， 就是说，因为 Krishna 要他控制这个心意。但是他告诉 Krishna， 事实上根本要控制心意实在太困难了，太困难了，心意是如此的躁动不安，如此的猛烈，如此的顽固，根本就没有办法制服得了。但是 Krishna 告诉他，是的，非常困难，但是如果透过就是练习， 和去除这个执着心的话是可以做到的。
So, in our practice of devotional service, these two things are very essential. The practice and also the detachment from the material sense gratification.
所以在我们奉爱服务的过程中，练习是极为重要的，非常重要的基础。而且我们也必须要，学习如何去，就是不依附、弃绝这个感官享乐。
All right. Are there more questions?
No, Maharaj, that's all for today.
Okay, so I think it's a good time to stop. We've been over time. And you need a rest.
我们现在已经有点超时了。我想马尔就说现在我们可以就是今天的讲课就到此结束。
So, Vama Fichan Ganshya Shamasundari Mataji, Gay Vama Gentai de Fun E, Vama Ganshya Soyo de Functionza Ling Ting, T1, Ganshya Niman Do Chanja, Jufu Niman,
Maharaj, Taigan Nina, Hare Krishna Maharaj,
Bao Zhong Shinti, Bao Zhong Shinti, Ju Yan Tuan, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada,
Srila
Prabhupada,
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 Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada, Prabhupada,